Hey and welcome to Ahrefs monthly product updates. We have 3 tool updates, 1 cross-tool update, and 4 general updates to share today. Let's start with Site Explorer. First up, we've just released the referring domains calendar. This lets you visualize all the day-to-day changes for new and lost referring domains in a calendar format. For example, we had over 100 new referring domains and lost 86 referring domains on the 5th of May. You can click and drag on the calendar itself to select several dates at once. From there, scroll down to see a breakdown of the referring domains for the time frame you selected below. The calendar report is available on new standard plans and higher, or legacy advanced plans and higher. Moving on, we've added the Inspect column to all link-related reports in Site Explorer. Just click on this magnifying glass icon to view that link in the source code of a referring page. We've also added a new Page Checks tab in the Inspect panels. This lets you view and compare text content of a page to see how it changed over time. Like with the HTML tab, the orange dots next to each crawl date tell you when there were changes in the page text. With this, you can now track how the text content of a page changed. Moving on, we've added the Homepage Links filter to all backlinks-related reports in Site Explorer. Use this filter to find backlinks from homepages or exclude them from the report. Moving on to one cross-tool update. We've added a new option to the Open In menu in the SERP overview tables in Site Explorer and Keywords Explorer. Now, you can select multiple targets and click Open in Overview 2.0 to quickly compare results. We've also added this function in the Organic Competitors report. So now, you can open competing domains and pages in Overview 2.0, Content Gap, and Link Intersect. Moving on to Site Audit. We've added a new section in URL details called Structured Data. It shows you structured data found on the page and also flags validation errors based on the schema.org guidelines. We've also added a new issue in all issues for validation errors of schema. As always, click on the question mark to learn more and see guidelines on how to fix it. We've also added fields for structured data properties and their values to Page Explorer. So now, you can build queries with them. For example, if we want to find all posts written by Tim Solo, we can apply a filter for the author schema property. And then we'll set a property value to those containing Tim Solo. Moving on to Content Explorer. We've added the URL rating metric to Content Explorer. Just click on it to see a trend chart in the History tab. Moving on to our general updates. First up, let's talk about our search traffic estimations. Earlier in March 2023, we updated our keyword volume estimates with the intention to make them more accurate. But thanks to many of you, we've come to realize that this update actually caused a decrease in search traffic estimations for many websites. So to fix that discrepancy, we recently rolled out another big update to our database. We updated our search volume estimations for around 16.6 billion keywords, with 1.1 billion in the US alone, and added over 20 million new keywords to our Keywords Explorer database. Also, we now have 650 million keywords in Site Explorer, with 170 million in the US alone. This update should make our traffic estimations go back up and really improve their overall accuracy. Future updates should not cause dramatic swings in traffic estimates. We wrote a full blog post on this update, which I'll leave a link to in the description below for you to learn more. Moving on to our API V3 updates. First, non-enterprise plan users will be happy to know that you can now test Ahrefs API V3 by running a limited set of free test queries that do not consume units. Learn more about the free test queries in our API V3 docs, linked below. And a couple of updates for enterprise users. We just released an endpoint for the matching terms report. As usual, you can use the API button to generate sample requests. We've also added an option to limit API units usage per key. You can do this from the API key section for workspace owners and admins. Moving on, we've just added an option for workspace owners and admins to limit and disable all pay-as-you-go charges from account settings. Whenever an individual user hits the limits set, they'll be notified in that tool itself. Moving on to our final update. We've improved the credits counter in the main header. Just hover over the usage level chart to learn more about your usage level. And that's all for today. If you have any feature requests, you can leave them on our Canny. See you in the next update and have a great day.